Okay, that was a little bit weird. Mike seemed to be picking up some external noise from somewhere. I imagined it was interference, and it turns out it was just not connected properly. And just dipped. Alright, so let's head over here. Alright, hopefully the music's not too loud and you can still hear me and everything. So yeah, thank you. Welcome back. Yes, we're going to be continuing building the My Lifeboat. So let me just refresh your memory. So it was the RNLI's 200th anniversary this year, and in order to honor that, I decided to relaunch my model bench, which I've been looking to do for a while now. I just needed something to adequately mark the occasion, and that's when I found out that the RNLI had it was their 200th year anniversary, so decided to build the Severn Class Lifeboat. So far we have we have painted the hull. It's now masted up, so that's gone. You won't see that for a while now until I've finished most other things. So we painted that, we painted the deck last week, and we painted many other little bits which are going to go onto the deck. I did say I was going to try and finish painting some of those bits with airbrush during the week, but I never got round to it. And also, you know, I think that's part of the stream, isn't it? All right, so what we're going to do is we're just going to continue with that. Again, I want to thank the RNLI for permission to use their videos. I might pump out one of their explanatory videos a bit later on, because I seem to want to do that once a weekend. You know, just to remind new people who are coming here what's going on. And also, thank you very much to the RNLI's social media team who gave me a bunch of information about who they are, what they do, some talking points, and stuff like that. So, you know, I hope you've all been taking note. But basically, they are a 100% volunteer service. They are not affiliated with the Coast Guard in any way. They do work with the Coast Guard sometimes to perform rescues at sea, but that's just the way that goes. But yeah, they're all volunteers from local communities. They design and build their own lifeboats in-house, and they are run entirely from public funding. So yeah, if you feel like you want to donate a little bit, the link is in my About section, and that also takes them to takes you to their website, and it gives you vast amounts of information and details about who they are, what they do, and especially about their 200th anniversary. I am not being paid by the RNLI to do this. I wanted to do it on my own, and I just contacted them and said, hey, I'm doing this. Is there anything you want me to say? And they're like, yeah, here you go. So yeah, it's not a paid sponsorship. It's all coming out of my own pocket because I would have built it anyway. So yeah, without further ado, I think we should just crack on and see what we got, shall we? Right, I'm hoping my cameras are all working this week. I did check them earlier and they did seem to be working. Oh yeah, that one's working. So yeah, we're going to, fingers crossed, they're all working perfectly well. So here's the boat so far. I did forget to paint these nobules where doors and bits and pieces go. They're going on the inside. So what we are ultimately trying to do now is we're trying to build the cabin. So we want to put everything into the cabin, paint everything up, get all that ready, put the cabin on. Then we're going to paint it in the trademark orange. Creamy! Why is... Hold up. Alright, so, you know, I'm having a bit of a trouble here. Hang on, let me go into studio mode here. Doggers! Doggers! Right, okay, so why is that not... save? That's really bizarre. Okay. Let me try and re-spin that, see if that works. Alright. Alright, for some reason, the sound from my alerts is not coming through, so let me try and reconfigure this, because for fuck's sake, I mean, hey Duana, hey, how are you doing? Let's try and do that again. Maybe that was the problem. Okay. Right, can we do it again now? There we go. I knew it was coming. Also, I refuse to bear with you. However, will bear with me. Are you sure that's the right spelling for that particular use of bear? You may be correct. I don't know. Hey Duana, how are you doing? Bastel bear, eh? Brilliant. Bear is proper term. Right, okay. Right, bear with me. Barbarian. You don't make me want to take my shirt off now. It's good to have you both. I'm assuming, Duana, you were napping earlier when I sent you the message. Creamy, well, good to see you. What was I saying? Oh yeah, I was having a bit of some technical difficulties earlier. My mic wasn't quite connected and I was getting a bit of feedback off of it apparently. Or some interference, and then it just cut out. It wasn't quite connected properly, so I had to put all that back in. So that obviously knocked out the OBS sound. But at least now we can hear our Charlie bit me and all my alerts and stuff like that. Hopefully the music is at a good level. It's not too quiet and not too loud. Let's bring up just a smidge. There we go. I'll try and, you know. So yes, let's get on with it, shall we? And it's great to have you with me. All right, so yeah, what I was saying is I forgot to paint these nobules. I've got to mask up the ship and paint these modules, so I'm going to do that today, which only means I just missed out on, I have to remix this paint and do one of these. So I mean, it's not a huge problem, but what I'm trying to do is I'm trying to build all the internals and the cabin, because then we can spray the cabin with the trademark orange, and then we can put on all the decals and mask up the decking and spray on the gloss coat, and then we can start adding all the other bits and pieces like the railings and all that kind of stuff that doesn't need the gloss coat. So that's what we're going to try and do. We're going to try and paint some more bits. So first of all, I've got to work out which one of these is okay. Right, so it's this bit here which I'm going to have to spray. So what we're going to do is we're going to mask that up first of all, then we're going to mix up some paint and we're going to spray that. So let's see if we can find some masking tape. We're going to go for a couple of hours today. I haven't quite been feeling a little bit off kilter recently, so Creamy knows what that's like. You're not feeling so good yourself at the moment, are you? So what I'm going to do is just mask this up to get some nice crisp lines again. This one shouldn't take too long to mask up because it is, of course, just a bit square. Saying, oh, why aren't you just painting it with a paintbrush? It's going to be much easier. Well, you're right. It will be quicker and easier, but it won't quite be as good. It won't be as uniform. And I do like to try and do things properly. Always have, always will. Personal pride, you know. I just feel you get a better finish with an airbrush, and you don't get all the brush strokes in it. Sometimes brush strokes and things like that are good, but not in this case. All right, so I'm going to try and so what are you doing out there today? Do I know you are still playing your what is it, game, your factory game? Creamy's probably still on Skyrim. Right, I'm going to take that out of the stand there for now. Well, not all day though. Surely, you know, when you weren't napping, you were doing something. Don't want to put that masking tape down too securely, because it is only decorators class masking tape, and it doesn't like you were learning your shapes today. That's right, you were learning your shapes. I remember now. How's your colors coming along? She's like, I'm gonna beat you next time I see you patronizing me. I'm sorry. So I'm just putting mask down just lightly because I want it to come off soon. And as I said before, it's just decorator's masking tape, which is not great. Yeah, next milestone is color mixing. There is colours in here. Oh my god, I'm sorry. I was just joking. Alright, okay. So when are you going to learn the alphabet? Like A is for apple. B is for bear. C is for... what are they? C is for cow. P is for punch. No alphabet involved. Okay, fine. So you know your alphabet. Good. You got good grades on your alphabet. All right, so as you can see, I've just basically just kind of made a fan shape around everything else. All I'm doing is going to be spraying directly onto this, and that's that. So we're going to put that away. Good, I'm happy with that. I took a nap today, and I was feeling a bit. So I was feeling a bit off. Do we really have the energy to do a stream? And I thought, I'll do one. I'll get out there and do one. I always feel better when I'm actually up and running. So I cleaned out my airbrush last week. After that kerfuffle, I mean, it wasn't too bad. It did take me a couple of hours to paint that orange, only because I mixed it a little bit thin. So we don't need much of this one. Just basically a couple of coats. I try and not make it too thin because I'm using one of those damn medicine things with the lips on the inside. What are you doing with this? It's just... Yeah, that should be right. Yeah, I mixed up that orange last week a little bit too thin, and it had, luckily it was only a small piece that didn't really make much difference, so I just kind of took a couple of hours, sprayed a bit, let it dry, sprayed a bit more, let it dry. Didn't turn out the best quality, but it is a kind of hidden detail, so it's not really too bad. When I come to actually paint the main body, this bit will probably be exposed and be painted again. So yeah, it's gonna be redone, I expect. Right, so let's move all this bullshit out the way. Right, okay, so airbrush. Hey, it's Amu. How you doing, Amu? Good to see you, Amu. How's your day going? I guess it's a little bit, a little bit early for you, isn't it? Isn't it? Hanging in there. Good, good, good. That's what it's all about. What's all about? Oh, you're joking! Oh, you son of a bitch! I checked these cameras earlier. I so checked them. Just check them again. All right, studio mode. Let's see if we could fix that camera. Oh, it's working now. Oh, great. Okay, so that freaking helps, didn't it? Da-da-da-da-da-da. Boom, there we go. Right. Hell. Right, okay. Alright, let's Uh-oh. You were working just a minute ago, what the hell? Oh, there we go. There we go. There we go, that's all I needed to do on that piece. So, yeah, that was it. That was all I needed to do. Bad cameras, bad. Yeah, I know. They. I'm going to have to try and get my friend around and see if there's something we could do about them because... Oh, look, this one's off on the glitch again. Oh my giddy aunt. Okay, that's not good, is it? Let's just stick it back to that for the time being. Alright, so why are you glitching? Let's see if I can get you to work. Ba 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 ba. Are you not? Yeah, you're not glitching out now. Alright, okay, so now we've got to clean that out. So picked up some, gonna run some MLP through it, I think. Gonna do. That, again, that bit of paint may have been a bit thick, but it's fine, it's done, it didn't need to do much. Let's run some of this through. I don't know why they do what they do, but I think it's got something to do with the fact that the computer gets confused as to which one's which, because they're generally all named the same. I don't know. I've got a friend who would know better than I do. I'm gonna have to get him around one day and sort of say, you know, because I specifically had this computer built to handle at least 5 webcams. Because the old one, I didn't need much power. It's not playing games. It doesn't need much of a GPU. It just, you know, it's not really a super powerful computer. So I thought I could just use my old one that I used to have, my old main one. Started plugging in the webcams, and they were just going bananas. They just didn't like that at all. And my friend said, well, it's because you need dedicated USB ports connect directly to motherboard and not get split, because otherwise too much information is going down one port, something like that. That's what he said. So yeah, you cleared out. I think you're cleared out. Yeah, so I got another one built, told him exactly what I wanted, and sure enough it did come with bunch more USB ports. So they all work. It's just, I think they seem to conflict somehow. I'm gonna do a little. Yeah, you can see the spray there, so it's spraying. Just gotta run that through. Now this is quite a good little thing. It's a little glass, quite solid glass holder. You can use it to hold your paint airbrush in it, and you can also use it to run chemicals through, and it stores the chemicals in the bottom. I've had this a little while, as you can see, it's held together with elastic bands. That's mainly because the teeth on the screw top has kind of gone a bit wonky. Probably it's the chemicals that I use will eat through rubber and plastic, so it's not. Have to get a new lid for it. Alright, so that's that done. Easy peasy lemon squeezy. Now we're going to go and mix up boat. Oh, it's, hey! It's Maeve. How you doing, Maeve? Yes, the boat is here. Boat is being done. So I want to thank you, Maeve. Maeve actually sent me, I was hoping you would join in. Maeve actually sent me something in the post the other day. It was, where is my main model bench? There we go. It was a Warhammer magazine, and it came with a couple of Warhammer figures. I haven't seen Warhammer figures on the sprue for such a long time. I thought I'd only received one. I was like, man, what's going on here? but you don't get many parts to a Warhammer figure. I was like, oh, right, okay. I was so used to these Airfix kits with hundreds of pieces. I forgot Warhammer pieces are very light on bits, so yeah. So anyway, Maeve sent me that in the post. Was it, what was the magazine? I can't remember what the magazine was called. It's right behind me. And I will do a, I will show it, but I wanted to leave that until I'd done the, until I've done my lifeboat here. So thanks very much, Maeve, for sending me that. I do appreciate it. I haven't painted Warhammer for years now, ever since I was much younger than I am now. Oh yeah, that's right, I've lost my bloody tweezers, haven't I? Well, I've got to use these ones that really confuse me. Yeah, so I haven't painted Warhammer for a while now. So it'll be interesting to get back and do that. And see if I do it. So yeah, we're going to, I'm going to show that off in its own thing. There we go. Nice and crisp and clean. Look at that, there we go. Brilliant. Right, so now we have to do matte black, and we've got to mask up these bits here. So, back to some masking. Did I put my masking away because I'm an idiot? Did I put my masking tape away? Did I? No, I didn't. I moved it. Come on. I mean, this bench isn't that big. Where the hell was it? Okay, I've got another roll. I can't keep doing this. I can't keep losing. No, it's over there. Ask the man with the mask. Yeah. Here it is. So yeah, thanks again, Maeve. I really do appreciate that. And I will do a stream where I actually paint them. Build them and paint them. What I think we'll do. Yeah. But I wanted to keep this very much separate. So didn't want to dilly dally jump between things. Gonna fit in there. Are you? Roll in. Yep. So these two things need to be black, which is fantastic, because that's exactly what we're gonna do with them. Once these are painted, we're going to start looking at some dry brushing. We're also going to start looking at some weathering and some inks, pigments. To like pick out some of these details of on the actual deck. No intention of weathering the hull itself. That's going to remain nice and clean and polished. That is like the showcase piece, you know? Piece that's going to draw the eye. Right, so that's that one masked. Right. How are you doing today, Maeve? Have you been working hard on your renders and stuff? I guess he's wandered off. Anyway. It's been a day. Oh, that one's not quite straight. Let's see if we can straighten that up. My last thing I want is a bit of black on the deck where it shouldn't be. So, oh my god. Come on, get in there perfectly. There we go. Now you're snug up against the side of it. There you go. Want nice crisp lines. Okay, so that's that. Should be masked up nicely. Right, is that dry yet? Oh, give it a minute or two. Just wondering, well, should I take these off now? I don't know, I think I'll keep them on there. I think I'll keep them on there for now. We are going to have to take them off pretty soon. Build a cabin. Put there. They're serving a purpose right now. Fantastic. And it's just I could just tear that bit off, couldn't I? Because I could use that. Okay. Are you going to be streaming today, Amu? That thing that's going to be happening. Maybe she's already streaming and she's just got me on in the background. I mean, why wouldn't you do that? Yes, you are going to stream. Oh, excellent, excellent. I'll have to try and catch that stream. That'd be great. Alright, so now we've kind of masked that little area up. That's fantastic. I mean, I know it looks ridiculous, but it does the job. Doesn't need to stay on there for very long, neither. Great! Brilliant. Alright, so let's move that out of the way. In 3.5 hours. Oh, excellent. Well, I'm hoping not to be on too long today. I'm just spending some time with some friends elsewhere. So well, maybe I'll have you on and catch you. Right, so I mean, it doesn't matter if I mix up this one. It's black and it's going to cover everything. Is this flat black? Yes, good. That's what I wanted. So we're going to need a little bit more than that. Right. It's not too much. I don't need too much. I don't want to waste too much. You always waste so much paint when you do it like this. I mean, honestly. No problem, Mamu. I'll try and remember. I mean, if you're streaming before, like just before I finish, I'll raid into you. Or try to. I mean, I haven't raided out on this machine. So I don't, it should work. I always end up getting the timings wrong as well. I'm like, yeah, bye, see you later. And then spend the next 2 minutes working out how to raid. Oh, well, never mind. Okay, so, wow, 6 viewers. Jesus, popular today. Okay. All right, so we're going to move over here. Doing it again. Oh, my God. I fixed the cameras. Don't speak too soon, Carrie, otherwise they won't. Right, so we're just going to pour a little bit of this in and see if it needs any more thinning. No, that seems to be about fine. Great, so I'm going to need some gloves for this one. I go through so many of these latex gloves, it's crazy. I feel as though I'm a rectal examiner. Alright, what next? Ugh. Right, I just usually use the buttons on the stream manager. That's what I usually do. And then it brings up the options as to who I want to raid. I click that. And then it gives me a time running down saying you will be raiding and ready to raid in 3, 2, 1, whatever. So. Alright, let's spray this black one here. Oh, turn the airbrush on. Away we go. Don't go spitting. Are you still too? Are you too thick? Oh, okay. Are you all right? See if we can get some around that. I don't know, there's a door that goes on there, so I haven't even been seeing that. That's right now it's flowing. Okay, good. So now we just got to paint the other bits. Bring them over here. That works too, but I've noticed not everyone I'm following is on that list. I've seen. Oh, really? Oh, okay. Alright. I like black. It's pretty, pretty forgiving color. Sorry, just paint it on. It's pretty much done. So that's that one. And this is a flat black, so it's kind of matte. The other one is kind of a semi-gloss black, so you're not really going to notice much difference in it, but it is needed. Or what I'm doing. So these should all kind of dry a little bit dull. And then and this is the computer panel. I don't know if you could see that. And it's going to have obviously it's the part with most of the buttons and knobs and things. So what I really want to try and do with this is actually work out what is going to be on those screens. I mean, I'm obviously not going to be able to paint what is on those screens, but mostly what color it is going to be, and try and paint within the cabin to show that those screens are lighting up or lights bouncing off of part of the cabin because of those monitors. That's what I want to try and do. So it's like kind of painting light. I've done similar things before. I'm going to try paint light on before. Oh, Arthur Morgan. Yeah, I painted light on Arthur Morgan. It didn't quite work out according to plan. But, you know. It's a learning experience. It's a learning experience. Right, again, I know we're just going to be painting black straight into here. But I do want to clean it out every time. And the more and more times you run some cleaner through, better it's going to be. I'm going to use that actually because I don't need it to be quite that strong. I'm just going to use the cheap airbrush cleaner. Got more of it. I did receive some, thanks to the generous donation from Aria, I did get my masks, and don't need to wear them at the moment because I'm barely doing anything at all. And also I got some more of the hardcore airbrush cleaner, the stuff that burn your eyes out, stuff that actually takes lacquer paint out of the airbrush. That stuff's nasty. But I like to run it through my airbrush a couple of times when I've completely finished doing what I'm doing, because then it just really just tears everything off. Gives it a really good clean, but it's nasty stuff. I'm just gonna run this through, should be fine. Hey, it's Aria. Hey, oh, she's lurking, is she? Okay, fair enough. Well, thanks, I've just mentioned you, Aria. There you go. Yeah, I am careful. I mean, I'm careful with the stuff. It's like, don't get it on your hands, don't drink it, basically. Or get it in your eyeballs. I mean, I think I could manage that. Not a child anymore. Yeah. What are you running through? Oh yeah, you are running through. That's good. Just put a lot in there, that's all. Yeah, I got it from, I'll have a look in a minute. want to show you the box. It's got my address on it, and I haven't prepared it. So. It's basically called Mr. Tool, and I get it from... get it from Premier Hobbies. I think Premier Hobbies. I can't remember where I get half this stuff from. I got a bloody long list of bookmarks. And I always have to look through each one. And go, where do I get that from? Where did I get that from? And where did I get that from? I have to like compile a list of where I get most of my stuff from. Oh, I'm going to take these gloves off because they make me sweat. And they're horrible. Right. So, we've now... bench. Right, so that's normal, that's flat black dough. I've now got to do black, which is I've not got a semi-gloss black. There it is, semi-gloss black. Right, and this one is just flat black. We don't need that no more. Put it back in my little box here. I've got a little box there. I have to go through all my paints at some point. I remember I ordered up a whole bunch of stuff I've already got. So I'm going to need to order myself another one of those wooden drawers just for paints. So I haven't got so many of these paints. I thought one would be enough. One drawer set would be enough. Apparently not. So what we're going to do now is we're going to mix up some semi-gloss black. Need another one of those mixer cups. Hey, welcome to the stream. I just noticed someone else had joined, so there's that. You want to know what we're doing? We're building a Severn Class lifeboat for the RNLI, or the RNLI's lifeboat, not for them. But at the moment, we're just mixing up some paint. So welcome, welcome, welcome. Right, so this is semi-gloss. I'm also going to gloss it up a little bit more once it's dry with some actual varnish. I hope that'll work. Should work. Hope your day is going great. Feel free to like sound off in chat or something. You know, I do like a conversation. And I can see it. Check to see how thin that is. Good. Pretty good. Maybe just a smidge more. Again, let me know if the music isn't loud enough. If it's like, because sometimes when music's in the background, if it's not loud enough and you could just about hear it, it becomes like somewhat annoying. So do let me know if that is the case. I will adjust accordingly. I don't have an editor to edit these things for me. Alright, I'm going to put on some more gloves. So many gloves. Right. Okay. Paint's out bench. Here we go. So. See if that flows correctly. We go, that should be good. A bit of spitting on there or whatever, but it's fine. Right, spray up these things. Do-do-do-do. Oh my god, this thing is so tiny. What the hell is that? Oh, that's the base to some of the seats, isn't it? Oh, hold up. Okay. Let's see how that fares on these seats here. Okay, so something's wrong. Not coming out. Spitting. Shouldn't be doing that. I think it's coming out way too watery. All right, so before we actually ruin everything with that, we're gonna have to readjust. Happens sometimes. So we're gonna just put in some more semi-gloss black, just try and thicken it up a bit, I hope. Looks as though I had the right consistency to start with, and I just overcautious and screwed it up. So we should be a little bit more consistent here now. All right, so I'm gonna go back over there and try and spray out. The trouble with the airbrush, it's all good fun, but it's so temperamental. Let's just try and work out, blow out what's already in there. Hey, more people have joined. Hey, welcome. So we were at the moment trying to paint the seats, and there's what, seven of them, because the Severn Class Lifeboat has a crew of seven. Not the reason it's named. It's named for the longest river in UK, the River Severn. Named after the River Severn, yep. Not for it. After it. Okay, now let's see what we got. I'm just gonna sort of... Come on, what are you doing? Ah, now we're talking. Oh, wait, no, it's still... Okay, it's not as bad. Alright, so what we're going to have to do is we're going to have to light spray it, give it a couple of coats. Do a light spray, and give it a couple of coats. So, I think I remember this from when I used semi-gloss black before. It's kind of... quite difficult to get as smooth. See, it's coming out quite spotty. We're just gonna try and lay it on in layers, I think, here. I'm certainly no airbrush expert. I mean, and this stream is by no means a stream run by an expert. It's just me who just likes making models, and I have, you know, I've got ideas of, some might say grandeur. No, No, I've got ideas of like how I want to do things, and I want to try and do things properly, like do good jobs and make them detailed. And I like those intricate details and things like that. So I'm by no means an industrial light and magic employee or anything like that. I'm just a hobbyist. I mean, I'll give tips and stuff like that, but these are just things that I've learned over my course of my time. So we've got this painted, but I don't know if you can see, but it's a little bit spotty. So we're going to leave it to dry, give it another coat, and then see what happens. So, perfect. Just going to leave that doing that. Turn off the airbrush. Right, we come back down to the main bench. Main model bench. Great. Okay, so now we're going to unwrap this. Unwrap my little Christmas present. All right, and again, we move back to the main hull and the deck. We go. So we've got a fair few. We've got a few viewers in here. If any of you know anything about the RNLI, then shout up. I highly doubt we've got a lifeboat operator in here. Sure, they got better things to do. Oh no! Bad news bears. Bad news bears. Yeah, that's a work. Ah, but that's not too bad. Oh, that could have been worse. Been so much worse. Okay. We had a leak, ladies and gentlemen. All right, so if you look at the back here, we've had a little bit of a leak, a little bit of a run, and that is because I didn't mask it up properly. Oh, and there's a little bit down here too. So what I'm going to try and do is grab some. Going to let that dry a bit more, and I'm going to grab some of this paint. I'm not going to worry about this leak because that is on an area that's going to get covered anyway. Actually, it might. I mean, might as well do it while I'm there, and so. Dark sea gray. Oh, then we get to get some paint brushes out. Paint brushes. Go through so many paint brushes. It's not even funny. Hey, the magic doctor, how are you doing? The ship has a leak. Save yourself. We are sinking. We should call the RLNI. Oh wait. We are the RLNI. Hey, Magic Doctor. Good to see you. Right, so I want to use that one that thick. Let's grab another one that's a little bit, probably a little bit thinner. So, well, that one's just falling apart on me. This one I do. You just got done fishing. Did you catch anything for supper? Hopefully you had fun out there and were safe. Now I don't usually like touching up like this. I mean, it's what you need to do, but the problem is once it dries as a kind of a different texture to airbrushed stuff, and you could definitely tell that you've touched something up that isn't airbrushed. But luckily it's not going to be in an area that's going to be too well seen. So, it's all good. All good. Allow, what's this? What did you say? Fishing is not safe, Perry. You're dealing with hooks. Oh, yes. Hooks. What's this? Drink, fool. Okay. All right. Oh, you can't even see me drinking. All right. I mean, I best put that on RNLI then. Shut up, OneDrive. Okay, we'll just drink. That's cold. That's cold coffee. Yeah. That's pretty cold. I'll go and get a lemonade in a minute. Thanks very much. Now I'm all hydrated. That's the word I was looking for. All right. So all right, I do love the interaction. It's great. Right, so what I'm going to have to do now is I'm going to have to go and get some water. I'm going to go and get some lemonade. Oh my god, the glass that I usually put water in has gone all manky. Look at that. Ugh. So we'll find something else to put water in. What have I got that I can put water in? I'll just get a glass, smell that. Cold coffee is better than my tongue is melting hot coffee. I'm used to cold coffee. I would always have a cup of coffee on my desk when I was working. And because I was just so busy and I would sometimes like end up not being at my desk for periods of time, like have to run off to this meeting, that meeting, go out on site, do this, do that, I'd come back and the coffee was cold. And it was like I either make a new cup of coffee, which was only going to end up getting cold anyway. So I just got used to drinking cold coffee. Because otherwise I'd be forever making a cup of coffee. I used to drink coffee like it was going out of fashion anyway. Like always in the kitchen making a cup. They're like, "Who in here again?" I'm like, "It's gone cold." Okay, so what we're going to do is going to go and get a glass of water for my brushes. We're also going to go and get a lemonade for my belly. So what we're going to do is we're going to do a bit of a BRB. And let me just check here. Let's just do a BRB. Be right back. All right, so I'm back. But seeing as the stream is fully underway now, we've got like 9 people watching. Excellent, Roger's in here. I see Roger, Amu, Aria, Creamy, Duana, the Magic Doctor, and Kiara Kitnip. Excellent. So a bunch of people I know is already in chat at least. As soon as we got the stream up and running, I'm going to take a quick break, a smoke break, I suppose, but let me do, wanted to do it in studio mode. I wish I had someone to edit this thing for me. It would just be so much easier. But, yeah. Okay, so what we're going to do is I'm going to take a quick break, have a cigarette. So while we got a bunch of people actually in stream watching, I don't know if you're new, but we're going to play the video that the RNLI was kind enough to give me permission, grant me permission to play. And it says, it gives a good insight as to who they are, what they do, what kind of people they are involved with. And it's a great little story. So I'm just going to give you that and we're going to go from there.
We can expect a restless night across the region. Gusts are forecast to reach up to 80 miles an hour throughout the night, with the potential for even higher bursts in isolated areas. Residents are urged to stay indoors and secure loose outdoor furniture.
It was probably blowing about 80, 90 miles an hour, roughly. And I said to my Mrs. Nina, I hope no one gets a shout tonight. And within sort of 20 minutes, my pager was going off. I've lived in England all my life. My mum's and my dad's sides are both fishing families. From my mum's side, originally from Mousel. I was destined to be a fisherman, I suppose. With a load of mates all wanted to be fishermen as well, so that's what we did. Love New England. I don't think I'll ever move out of New England.
Hello.
How are you,
Pat? All right? I'm fine. This does the best pasties in New England, and sandwiches.
It's a great community. We all have a bit of fun. Yeah, it's just a great place to be. You know, I haven't heard wind like that for a long, long time. It was screaming.
Your heart sinks, you know? You just think, oh no, I don't want to go out in that. You don't want them out in that.
So on the show that night, Marcel was duty mechanic, so he was obviously down getting the boat started up and prepared. I picked James Roberts as a navigator, and then I picked Will Trenier, who's also a fisherman. He's a helmsman. I also picked Trevelyan Worth, and I also picked Adrian and Dan Sell.
Took one sea that actually took us over on our side, and the wave just picked us up and threw us, no exaggeration, 50 or 60 meters down with the swell.
And I said, I think the only option we got with this is to try and get a rope on them and getting them out into deeper, safer water before we try and get anyone off.
Patch is usually very easy on the throttles and stuff, and the need for extra throttle for manoeuvring in that weather, you could really tell, especially with us standing back up above the engines. So you could tell how hard he was working just to keep the boat in position.
Because we were doing about two and a half knots, I suppose, with the yacht behind us, and the rope was quite tight. And then all of a sudden the rope goes slack and you're up to like five knots. So I knew straight away that the rope had parted. My heart sank when that happened. And I think all the crews did as well, because that, you know, we just realized that we've got less time to try and get the rope on again before it's too late.
The reality starts to set in when you can see the lights from the shore and realize how close we are.
One of our crew members come in, checked if I was okay, and I was like, I'm feeling quite poorly, and I was slowly getting worse and worse and worse, to that point where I was like, I wanted to be off this boat.
At this stage, Marcel had collapsed. He was unconscious. So the crew were dealing with him.
Glad they got honored in the way they did. They are true heroes, because remember, they do all this voluntarily. Anyway, okay, so we've had a little bit of a break. So what we're going to do now is switch over to the main model bench. And so it's looking a bit flat, if you know what I mean. It's looking a bit flat. So there are details here like the hatches. Let's bring the camera down a little bit. So there are details like the hatches and things like that that could do with a little bit of pulling out the detail. So they've got markings around them, but again, it's kind of flat, is what I'm saying. So, and especially this hatch at the front here, it just kind of looks a bit grey and a bit flat. So what we're going to do is we're going to use a wash to start with, and we're going to try and wash over some of this, the details, and hopefully what happens is the wash will fill in these crevices, and it will cause it to pop out the details. Now, I did have a wash or a couple of washes, but I can't find them. They're not in the drawer marked inks. What's that? Inks, weathering, and pigments. I have inks in here, blue and violet, but I washes. And I do have a stone grey for black wash, but I can't find my black wash. So I'm not sure what I've done with that. So I'm going to write that on my board. I need a black wash. Black wash. That's going to go on my shopping list. Again, using the money that was graciously donated to me by Aria. Thank you very much. So, what I can do is I can use... I do have some Indian ink. I'm kind of reluctant to use Indian ink. I've never really sort of used it before on any model making. Don't know how it's going to react. I don't know how to thin it. I use the inks for heat treatment, like exhaust pipes and manifolds and things like that that look as though they've been heated. You know, they heat up in all those blues and oranges and stuff like that. That's what I use inks for. So, yeah, I'm not sure I should use that. Or, generally what a wash is a very watered down or thinned version of the paint itself. So I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to take some flat black, or just some black, just some normal black, put it into a mixing cup, and then just really thin it down, just like almost water, because then what you do is you get a brush and you just kind of dip it in, and then you use a cotton bud and just wipe it away, and what it does is it leaves marks and weathering in the right place. So I think that's what we're going to do. We're going to just use a wash. So we're just going to thin this right down. Like, that is just crazy thin. I wouldn't paint with that, and I wouldn't even put that in an airbrush. That is just, I mean, it's just water at this stage. How thin that is even, it could be even thinner, honestly. So I am going to have to buy some proper washes. We'll put that on the list, and we'll get those from Premium Hobbies, I think. Look how thin that is. It's so watery. Just pooling like water. So I think what we'll do is, right, we'll give this a go. Alright, so we're looking at this, we're going to look at this piece over here. So what I need to do is I need to get out some cotton buds. Got tissue. I've got my toilet tissue there. Right. Because seeing as this is a, or this is not an actual proper wash, I'm gonna need to get rid of that really fast. So, just let it just soak. There you can see. You can see it following those contours. Wash all that over. Now, grab that and just this is why I prefer to use proper washes, because you really get them off. what I've done here is I've just kind of stained the paintwork a little bit. Not necessarily a big problem. I mean, but it means I'm going to have to be a little bit quicker. Oh, you can see it flowing through there. Also adds to the weathering. Yeah, it looks a bit of a mess on there, but that's just because it's wet and it's the light's picking up the wet. But I mean, I'm not particularly pleased with that, so we'll try and just clean it up a bit. All right, so this wash, okay, so I mean, it looks a bit weathered and it looks a bit used, but it's not quite picking up what I want it to pick up. Okay, so what am I going to do if I haven't got any wash? Why don't I have... Oh, I got another place where I've got paints and stuff. Did I put my washes in here? Yeah, there it freaking is. Freaking, there we go. I knew I had one. God damn it. Heroic. All right, so we can... What's that outside? Just use one of these cups because I don't need to mix it up. I can see that, you know, it's acting better. It just sort of uses capillary action to just spread itself around the area. I'm not too worried about that because that's... So what this will do is if I spread it all over the deck too, it will sure, it's not going to look as flat and crisp as it did before, but the deck is supposed to be a little bit somewhat used. This is what's the weathering process. That'll dry back. That'll be fine. So I'm pretty happy with that. So let's see if we can do a better job. I mean, I say pretty happy with that. Let's see if we can do a better job on this one. Let's go. Oh, Brian! Hey! Hey, Roger! How you doing? I didn't think you were streaming again tonight, Brian. I thought you were heading off to bed or something. Roger Dodger. I was lucky to find myself in a position where I was up earlier today than usual, and I managed to catch some of Brian's stream, do a bit of a rhythm games, then testing cars for Goliath 50. Oh, excellent. I managed to catch a bit of Brian's stream this morning, and yeah, it was good to hang out with you and chat with you and, you know, have a bit of a laugh and a joke. And, all that kind of good stuff. We're now just kind of weathering the, just kind of weathering now. Yeah, it was fun. We have a few really unexpected. What, for Goliath 50? Really? Interesting candidates. You'll have to let me know what they are. Anyways, I got to get to work on your TTS. Oh, thanks, man. It's going to function as a browser source in OBS, so you can just drag the HTML file straight in. It should work. Oh, fantastic. Thank you very much, my friend. That would be really cool. Yeah, like I said, no rush. I mean, no rush. I'm just... take your time. You're like, oh my god, Carrie, what have you done? You've painted it black. No, I haven't painted it black. I've washed it black. That's what I've done. Just a wash. Don't be too scared. It's fine. Actually, I'm going to use a polishing cloth here because they don't have... God, that's not... Right, okay, fine. Didn't have too many bits on it, so. Ah! Just bring that up so you can see a bit better. Okay. Well, thanks very much, Brian. I really do appreciate that. It's awesome. And hello to all the new people. What are we up to? 13. Good God. I'm gonna pay a little bit more attention to this hatch. In a minute, but I'm just kind of Oh, this has got actual polish on it. That should be fine. Blow it off. It's as you can see, around the hatch there, we've got like some looks like dirt and use. It's not quite as flat anymore, so that's what I'm after. So we're also going to just coat it a bit more with some of this. Take one of these and just wipe it off. Fantastic. I like how Brian comes in. Everyone's been excitedly watching a Forza stream. You know, all the cars have been steaming around at high pace. Lots of excitement, crashes, swearing, all that kind of good stuff. And then he finishes his stream and raids on me, who is just kind of chilling. Right, so as you can see, this is starting to look, if it will focus, starting to look a little bit more zoom, zoom, zoom paint. Yeah. I need the chill vibe since I'm about to crash into bed. Okay, Brian, you can stay as much as you like, as long as you like. So you can see that what we've done here is it's starting to got some depth to it, and it looks as though it's like actually a hatch that's been used. You know, there's some like maybe oil marks around the outside. There's kind of it's just kind of been, it's no longer perfectly flat and uninteresting. It's actually now a feature. I mean, if you look at hatches and things like that on boats and things, I mean, over the years, as oil has been used on the hinges and stuff, that leaks out, stains the metalwork. I mean, I know this boat isn't supposed to be that old, so I'm not really going to town with too much weathering. We'll do some dry brushing too in a bit. But you know, it's just had a bit of a battering from the sea a little bit, and it's kind of, you know, it's a bit more of a, where is it going to focus on it, or do I have to lift that up a bit more? Here we go. I need some better cameras, honestly. But so yeah, it's more of a detail now. So excellent, we're going to carry that on around. I think these hatches down here could do with a little bit more work. Weathering is always something that you think, just how much do I need to do? It's always one of those things that just, I don't know, I just love doing it. With Adam Savage on this one, it's great. Spend hours just weathering a model. Now we got some, and also it's like, it doesn't really matter as well if you like don't get it where it should be or whatever. It's like, it's entropy. It's just random. So if you can make something look random, You know? I mean, I know it's showing as a bit dark on the stream there. Let me try and get a light in this way. I've got this light over here. Let's see if we can get that in here. Oh my god, I've knocked over my airbrush. Oh god, goo just fell out of the... Oh, and paint is everywhere. It's not good. Oh my god, is that my... Oh, that is my... Well, that was a disaster. Which reminds me, I still need to paint these seats, don't I? So we'll have to come back to that. So let me see if that's helping. Right, okay. So yeah, that's helping a little bit. You can see a little bit. I know it looks a bit dark on stream, but it's not quite that dark here for some reason. Just the lighting. We're also going to do the stairs here. We're going to jack in some whack into these little step corners like that, and just. There and rub it out. Actually, what I'm going to do here, get a bit of masking tape, try and tape. Because it's moving around a bit. I don't want to do that. It's that side. And that should hold it. I mean, it's not held it 100%, but I don't want to hold it too much. I'm just going to get around a bit. Alright, so I'm pretty pleased with the way that's looking. Let's bring that up. I'm pretty pleased with that. I'm going to do the stairs on the other side. Let's see if we can move that out of the chat. Then just get a bud and just wipe it out. Yeah, that's you know, that's done pretty well. I might just knock a bit of black into the actual stairs there. Here. Just to sort of pick out. Got the back of the treads there. Okay, that's looking pretty good. Alright, so we've also got this hatch over here. We got some bits and pieces on the deck here. Now I think they're not super highly detailed. So we're gonna try and pick out what we can. Welcome back, Maeve. Add a command. Meow, you want me to meow? Is that good? How's that? Bad face. All right, so let's just wash over this deck. oh my God, Carrie, what are you doing? You're painting it black. You spent so long getting that nice, clean look to it, and now you're painting it all black. Oh my God. Nope. That high. Oh, hey, hi, Maeve. Yeah, Maeve is here. Yeah, I have to find a better rag. This is not working out. Oh, God, my shelf is wobbling. Oh, that'll be why it's covered in polish. It's been in the polish drawer. Let's try and find something else in here that we can use. Oh, they're all covered in polish in here. Ah, it's that silk one I was using. That'll work. That won't leave hair all over the place. Or dust. There we go. Just so I have some depth of texture, really. That's all it is. It's just kind of like taking away the flatness of everything. And I do like washes. Washes work really well, apart from, you know, I was trying to put down some acrylic. It'll do in a pinch. That'll do in a pinch, but can't be actual wash. Yeah, that's looking pretty good. And like these areas here where they're kind of, you could see the back here, you've got like a little bit of a line between the two. I'm not too worried about that because it looks like water wash, you know, where water is washed up onto the deck and it's kind of brought with it gunk and crap. And it's kind of stained it a little bit. All these, this is stuff under the computer terminal. Again, like I'm saying, I'm not trying to build an old boat. But I do want it to look as though it's been out on the sea. You know, it's done work. You know. And I know what you're thinking. But Carrie, all that lot's gonna be inside a cabin. You're not gonna see it. Well, that's the thing. I'm not entirely sure what you will and won't see once you look through the windows. The thing about a model is you're drawn to the initial model either by the bright paintwork of the hull or whatever. Get closer and you start looking in the windows and seeing what you can see, you know. And that's when you start picking up on details that have been put in it. And that's what I kind of want my models to be. Like all my car models and things like that are all sort of encourage you to like take a look inside. Right, so just want to do some more washing around the outside here. Like, as you can see, the wash has started to dry. Back, not quite so vivid. Let's pick out those details quite nicely. So in order to do some dry brushing in a minute, we're going to get I don't know if we should we could do some dry brushing on this, that'll be fine. I don't think this is going to be much that needs to be dry brushed, honestly. That's looking good. Oh, we've lost a few people. Well, I hope you've had I hope they had fun and they had fun and enjoyed seeing what I was doing. And usually over a course of a stream you're gonna lose people, aren't you? But yeah, it's all good. How's that looking? Yeah, not too bad, not too bad. Guess the raiders went away. Yeah, maybe. Yeah, but I was sitting on about I think about 8 people before the raiders came in anyway, so but you know, streams change, people go off and do other things. Good. They stay for quite a while, so, you know, showed some interest, which is awesome. Like, I mean, I honestly don't really do this for interviews. It's more of a, I mean, I would be doing this without Twitch. It's just, you know, come on in and check it out. It's always nice when you see people go, what's this idiot doing? What's this moron doing? Yeah, not zoomy zoomy. But it's all good. I'm not criticizing them on that. They didn't sign up to come in here, did they? Can't see me smiling. That was Brian. Like, right, guys. Done some zoomy, let's go and see some idiot paint a boat. What? Right, so I really think that's brought that deck to life. Really pleased with the hatch here. Bits and pieces of the hatches on the sides, staining on the deck. It's not overbearing, it doesn't make it look super old, just makes it look as though it's been out in the water for a little bit. Parts of the deck might be a still bit wet, you know. It's looking pretty good, looking pretty good. So I'm gonna quickly try and paint some more of those seats. So let's head over here to the and try and actually get some light over there without knocking everything asunder. Right, now what I've done is I've actually... There we go. It just needed another coat. That's all. All right, there you go. That's much better. I just needed to let that first coat dry and then bring in a second on top of it. We haven't got that much paint left in here because I knocked it over. But I'm hoping after this dries, not gonna need it. So we'll... Now this bit is way too small for you to see, but at least it's only doing something. All right, so let's have a quick shifties under the light here. Ooh, we could do with painting the base of the seat, or the actual bottom of the seat there. Let's see if we can get in there. Alright, we are pretty much running out of it, paint there now, but I'm going to leave that to dry and see if it does need another coat. Hoping it doesn't. Oh crap, don't fall over on me, dingus. Alright, just, oh wait, I don't know why, it's doing that. Wait on one side. Okay, so, brilliant. How long have we been going for? We've been going for nearly 2 hours. Wow. You're going to do some outside painting. What, as in... as in painting the fence? Or, you know, get out there in the sunlight. God, look at all this crap I've got over here. Alright, we're going to do some dry brushing in a minute, but I do want to have a quick smoko. So, sorry. It's going to happen. Alright, so what I'm going to do now is I'm going to dig through my paint drawer and see if I can find kind of a metallic. I want a kind of a metallic paint. Yeah. So let's do that. Let's dig through your paints. I wonder if I've got any in here. Oh wait, I might have. What's this one? That's air. I don't need air. I want a kind of like aluminium metal color exhaust manifold. Nope. Metal color aluminium. Is that air? Airbrush colors. God damn it. I think these are all just my airbrush colors. Yes. Air. No, they're... this is the whole Vallejo section. Well, there's glossy black. I already had glossy black. I really need to do something with my paints to work out what I've got here. What's this? This is another airbrush one. Oh! Did I? We have a Cinderblock octanical planter big enough to be the centerpiece of a backyard. It's an old wood top with metal brackets on it. A wooden metal need a repaint. What the 40th year to be in? Yeah. I'm sure that'll turn out real nice. Let's put those away properly. I've got... No, that's glue. Metallic aluminium. What am I showing you that camera for? There we go. We got some AK aluminium. So that's fantastic. Let's put that wash over. Oh, I might be able to just pull that wash straight back into here. Try not to waste any. Oh, God. Bubble I have to pop. Boop. Really don't want to necessarily see here what I'm doing. Right. So after 4 years, that'll look really good once that's done. Be sure to share a picture like that in Discord, Amu. You know. I know it. Sometimes it seems that people just don't pay attention to what people post in there. But, you know, we do. We are interested in what people get up to, you know. October over the boat. So, yeah, by all means. It's what it's for. Right, so I'm going to take some aluminium paint and I'm going to do some dry brushing. So what this does is I've done applied a wash which weathers flat areas, as you've seen. It makes it look like a little bit stained here and there. Also, what it does is it applies dark areas to recesses, kind of like shadows and stuff like that. This dry brushing is going to pick out highlights. Oh, wow. Okay, cool. You should totally do that. You should totally turn it into a veggie garden. I'll be super interested to see pics of that. Alright, so let's get back to this main model bench. Alright, so I'm going to pick a brush from my brush collection. A brush that I can dry brush with. So what I'm looking for is a brush that is not in pristine condition, but it's also kind of... It's not like my best brush, you know? Seen better days. And this one is probably perfect, honestly. And it's got a bit of blah, blah, blah around it. But that... probably fine. I might trim those hairs off. That might be fine for a dry brush. So let's just start doing my skizzers. Skizzers. I mean, I have everything to hand in some place. My problem is not putting it away when I'm done with it. So let's just trim this off. Let's just give it a little bit of a haircut. Stop these fucking bits sticking out. I just give that a bit of a haircut. There you go. That's it. All right. So this isn't my best brush. And I don't like veggies that much, so I was happy to see it go splat. Used to be that mum got the point, she couldn't keep up. Don't like veggies. I mean, who likes veggies? You've got to eat veggies, though, Amu. Part of a balanced diet. Honestly, now speaking from experience, I guarantee you, if you were to turn that into a vegetable garden and tend it and look after it and grow the vegetables and like, oh, look, there's my vegetables. Look at them grow. Hello, little fella. What's the matter with you? And you're out there most days watering it and looking for it. I guarantee you those vegetables will taste way better when you actually come to harvest them and cook them up. It's almost as if you can taste the effort you've put into growing them. You know what I mean? So, highly recommend that if you can. It's a nice little hobby too. I used to have a little allotment. Right, so I need a... I'm going to use my wet palette. No, I don't, because I'm dry brushing, aren't I? Duh. Right, so I've got a bit of a crappy old palette here. Fuck, there's a little... Ew, it's just a fly. Okay. I've got a bit of a crappy palette. They all feel woody. It's more of a texture thing for me, and they all feel woody. Well, you're not cooking them up properly. Get a vegetable steamer. Ah, a vegetable steamer. If I ever cook my own vegetables, I always put them in a steamer. Yeah, peas and carrots and things like that. Stick them in a steamer. Oh, I may have put out too much there. Alright, so what we're going to do is we're going to grab Mr. Crappy Brush. Coat him with... I mean, I know you can't see what I'm doing, but I'm just coating him with this aluminium paint. Oh, it's got fucking hairs and shit because it's a crappy... Oh my god. Right, and then I'm just going to dry him off. Pretty dry. Gonna get most of that paint off. Okay. Most of that paint off. Good. Then. Maybe still a bit more paint needs to come off. Don't want it to be super bright. Just kind of like. Just highlight the edges. There we go. Bring it down a bit. Now it's got some highlights to it. So we'll just sort of do that with some of these bits and pieces. There's not too much I want to dry brush. Maybe the corner, the edges of the steps here. There you go. Just pick out a bit of highlight there. There you go, as opposed to the other ones. Got a bit of a highlight on them. Fantastic. All right, I'm just going to do that one too. I don't quite know whether they covers that, but we're still going to do that. Alright, that brings out the hatch. Alright, so now what I'm also going to do is I'm going to do some dry brushing on this black. I have to bring out some of the corners and the details on that. Edges, some highlights. There we go, that looks great. I love dry brushing. It's the one thing that if you get it right, it just adds so much more. Look at that, that's not light hitting that, that's the dry brush. Gonna dry brush this bit over here. I'm not sure how much of this is actually seen. Whether something goes on top of it. Yeah, right. Same with this bit. This bit might need a bit more because it's already a light color, so it's already doing its thing there. Fantastic. Alright, okay. There you go, look, you can see that there, on this piece here, all this highlight and everything, it just makes it pop. So we're going to also do a bit of dry brushing on the edge here, along this railing, and it's already, it's bringing out some highlights. Doesn't need to be much. It's, I mean, remember, like, highlights are just kind of subtle things. You don't want to make it look shiny. Oh my god, that's amazing. I don't, yeah, you can somewhat see that as opposed to that. Yeah. There we go. So we're going to need a bit more paint because we have run out entirely on there. So just a smidge, don't need too much. Yeah, there's too much on that. God damn it, it's too much still. Picking out, it looks as though like some cables or rope has scraped the deck there a little bit. It's gonna bring out the screws and the hatch handles here. The hair on there, look. Jesus. Come here, little son of a bitch. So we just brought out some of the hatch handles and the screws there. Along the edge. Didn't bring out anything on the other side, so we'll try that. Yeah, it looks like it's got a bit of a scraping on here and there. Again, it's all weathering and detail stuff. Now, we don't need to go overboard with dry brushing. Fantastic! I am really happy with that. Let's put the other brush in the water too. All right, that's great. Right, so now we can put the boat aside for now. And look at some of these other pieces that we've got. I'm just trying to think, so give me a minute here to figure something out. I want to check my seats. How do they look? Oh, they're looking nice. They're looking all right now. Yep, they're looking pretty cool. Yep, so what we're going to do is we're going to spray those up with a bit of a varnish in a minute. Just to give them that extra shine, because I'm guessing they are either black vinyl or black leather seats or something like that. You know, proper seats there. All right, so let's put this aside. Let's put him up out the way. Let's have a look. Right, so we got a few things up here on these spigots, which could definitely use some I'm wondering, should I mean, some of these, there's some panels here and here that could, do I want to install them then? No, let's, especially these panels, we're going to dry brush these panels and weather these panels, because seeing as I've got access to move them around, it's going to be easier to get in to all the nooks and crannies. So we're going to do that. But I think what we can also do today is we can start gluing some of this stuff to the main deck. Start building up the interior. That will be freaking awesome. Right, so let's take some bits and pieces here. Right, so we got this, and there's a lot of detail and bits and pieces on here. These handles, I think, were painted white. So we're going to have to paint those, I'm sure of it. Let me check. It's that one. What's on the door? Door. Oh, it's... Ah, yes, the handles are white. 22 is white, I think. 22, white, yeah. All right, great. So... put the crappy pallet away. What the hell? Right, so this is quite an ingenious thing, and I recommend if you're doing any painting, you should get one of these. Oh, it's looking kind of crappy. Yeah, I might need to replace those bits. This is a wet palette. I mean, ignore that. Ignore that. If you do any amount of painting, one of these is going to be your best friend. Maeve will testify to that. It's known as a wet palette. This. So what you do is you pour water on it. Bit more there, just slosh it around a bit, and it's kind of a cloth which sort of soaks up water. Wrap on there. I think I might not need this. Oh, it's worth showing anyway. Is you just sort of let it soak up the water. Then you also get these kind of thin pieces of tracing paper, and you apply that top. Make sure it stays down. It's gonna curl up at the edges. Who's in the water too? And what you could do is you can apply your acrylic paint directly to that. So what we'll do is, instead of using wow, so quickly run out of room, it's not even funny. Right, instructions go over there, tobacco over there, brushes over there. So instead of using my this is an acrylic white, I think. Another white. This is a Vallejo model color white. Yeah, that'll do. Squeeze it on there. Perfect. And it'll keep it nice and wet for you to be able to paint with. It's amazing. So I'm going to move that to one side. Find a nice detail brush. Nice quality detail brush. There we go. Oh! Not what I want. That one I do. be honest, though, that's a nice way, and I wanted to show you how that wet palette worked. I think I'm going to stick with Tamiya. I think it's a little thicker. Wait, have I thinned this white? Did I thin that white? Sure, I thinned that. Oh, let's try this. There you go, that's thicker. Good. Wow, it's been a while since I've actually done any hand painting. I need to be a little bit steadier. Come on, Gary. Concentrate. Breathe. Alright, so that seems to be those two. I'm also going to assume... I mean, I know what assume does, but I'm going to assume that this is also white. This here is a seat. So what we're going to do is we're going to grab some semi-gloss black. Oh, actually, I have gloss black, don't I? I'm pretty sure I saw some gloss black. Bottle air. Do I see gloss black? Oh my god, there's so many different colors in here. I need... that's model air. That's just humble. Again, they don't... Humble 85, whatever the fuck that is. Alright, we'll just use... black gray. No. I mean, it's like kind of... Yeah, that's model air. Alright. It's kind of like going through like Lego. Like when you were a kid, you're like, oh, where's that one-er? Where's that four-er? Where's that gone? And you just spend hours looking through your Lego because it's all just thrown into one huge bucket. We had this huge kind of Tupperware like storage box. Big blue one it was, and all my Lego was just thrown into there. You'd spend hours just looking through it just for this piece. Okay, that's that. Right, stick that back in the thing. Where are you? Right, is there any more that I need to do here? Any more? Yeah, there's one here. Yeah, that one could be painted. Oh, there's a fire axe on that side. Look, so that's going to need... I didn't see that. Alright, so we're going to need to find... Ooh. do that before we do anything else. So I'm going to need to find. What do you reckon? Do you reckon it's going to be a wooden fire axe? What do you reckon? Wooden fire axe or a black-handled fire axe? One of those carbon. It's probably going to be a carbon fire axe, isn't it? I mean, come on, let's face it. You're not going to have a wooden fire axe on a lifeboat. Paint that black. Oops. Okay, so now, so I don't know if anyone can answer this question. I mean, I could look it up online. But typical fire axe, is the handle, is the axe itself, the axe head, red? Or is it mostly, I know it's going to be aluminium, but is it going to be, is there any red on it? And if so, where is it? Because I thought it was on the back of the handle. Let's just do a check. It's not going to take me long to find picture of a fire axe, is it? If I can move to get my keyboard here. Fire axe. That is completely red head. You might want to put some yellow on it, though. Okay, all right. So we'll wait for that black to dry, and then we'll put some yellow on it, too. So we're going to pour out some aluminium. Oh, I just did that. Want it definitely recognizable as an axe. Grab that. Give that a minute to dry off. In the meantime, I can find a yellow. I've got a red. So I've got my red here. Has this one been thinned? That one's good. And a yellow. Oh, yep, there's a yellow. This isn't transparent, you know. It's lemon yellow. Okay, good. That's what I need. Have I got a thinner brush? Come on. It's a ruined thinner brush. Ooh, hello, you. Right, so what we're going to need to do is probably give this a couple of coats, because let's face it, I'm painting yellow onto black, which is just a stupid idea. Should have done it the other way around. Okay. Well, it's got a yellow stripe on it, so it could be seen easily in underwater or whatever. I suppose this is used in case of an emergency, and heaven forbid the lifeboat actually sinks, they can actually get out. So they're going to want to see it in the dark. So there we go. There's a nice yellow stripe on the handle of it. I mean, these things are, you know, generally unsinkable. Except about the Titanic. These have a little bit more technology in them than the Titanic did. But, you know, planned for the... plan for the worst, hope for the best. Right, so now we're going to do the red of the axe itself, and from what the internet said, it was like a big red axe head. Alright, might need to give that a bit. Yeah. A little axe. I know it doesn't look fantastic right now because it kind of looks as though it's just standing on a grey background, but again, once it's been weathered, washed, dry brushed, pretty sure that's gonna. I mean, it's going to stand out close to, but I think it's going to look a little less out of place. Okay, good. So there's that. Fantastic. Right, we'll put that in here. Oh, no. This one needs... is that a fire extinguisher? Yes, there's a couple of fire extinguishers here. Right, okay, so what I'm going to need to do now... Well, that's interesting. Oh my god. Can I just... Over. Okay, so what we've got on this... Let me show you here. We've got a couple of fire extinguishers. Now, I'm not entirely sure which... What fire extinguishers they are. I have to call a guess. Now, obviously, let's just see if I can find Severn Class Lifeboat Cabin Internal, I guess. Cabin Internal. So, are there any pictures of this Severn Class Lifeboat that we can grab off the intertubes and see if so we're gonna go images. Oh my god, that's all right. So here's a cabin here. Let's have a look here. That's the back, but that's not gonna help. Rear cabin. Oh, there's some more. Sorry, I know you can't see this. I really should have a screen set up where you can see right, there's a lot of different color in here. Is that what I'm looking for? My god, it's just alright. Alright, I can just flick through these. Hold on. Oh, a lot of these is like wooden and stuff in here. Wow, okay, so this is going to be a huge resource for me. Right, so there is a red fire extinguisher. This piece, okay, so this piece looks as though... I'm pretty sure that's not it, though. It's not it. God, there's no... They've got coffee machines in... Cabins, bunk beds, sleeping quarters. Oh my god, there's so much in there. Oh my god, there's so many pictures of the engines. All right, so what I'm gonna have to do is, I think what we're gonna have to do is just try and make the best guess. And I think it's just gonna be a red fire extinguisher with a... there's so much here. There's a whole bunch of crazy detail in here. Oh, right, okay, so I know you. I can't show it to you, but... Right, so what we're going to do is we're going to make a best guess as those of red fire extinguishers with silver tops. I'm going to have to bookmark that, I think. Wait, that isn't... Is that even a... Calling that the RNLI 52 class. That's not even the right class of lifeboat that I'm looking for. I'm looking for the Severn. All right, okay. Right, so what I'm going to do later on today is I am going to look at some resources to see if I can find out what is what and where it where. So in the time being, we will, as it is, I think. All right, so right, so we're gonna have to be gentle with this. Get in there. Yep. Okay. Oh yeah, so now we have a little one of those. Alright, so we have been going for about... Oh, what is the time? The time is like... It's 9 almost. Well, it is 9:30. So what we want to do is... Wow, we haven't really... Like, done a great deal. Yeah, so I need to find the resources for, I don't know if the RNLI will actually have any interior shots of the lifeboat. They might do. That's something they're likely to release. It's not top secret. Might be on their website. didn't see any the last time I was on there. But I'm sure some enthusiast somewhere, some lifeboat operator, has posted pictures of the internal of it somewhere online. Right, so we're now going to use the white, paint the handles. People out there screaming, just put it together. These things won't be rushed. When I was younger and I used to get like a Christmas present of a model kit, yeah, I used to sit down with my granddad and dad and my uncle, and we used to bang it out in an afternoon. I never really had any paints, and if I did, I only really got the ones that came with the model. Just used to like, knock it up. No? Kind of a family, or an attempt at a family bonding thing. Granddad was, at the time, was usually, my granddad and my uncle were usually the ones that sort of paid an interest in it. Dad died. Dad's dad, that is. And so we used to sit there on the leaf dining table and make one of my models. It was really kind of fun. But like I said, we could knock it out in an afternoon because we just followed the instructions. We didn't necessarily paint it. We didn't take time or details. We just stuck it in there. When we were doing cars or airplanes, all the glass fogged up because I was using the wrong glue. But it was fun to just hang out and do stuff with these two guys. I never had an airbrush as a kid. That's a new thing. I did paint my model kits when I was doing them on my own. It was all with brush, and I was really just not happy with the way they looked. So generally didn't paint them. Very interested in yeah, it was a really good idea of mine to not fix these to the hull first. I think what's happening is I'm getting a little bit kind of maybe a bit self-aware that people want to start seeing me put it together. It's been a while. All I've been doing is really just taking things off and not really putting much together since we put the hull together. I think what it is I'm a little bit aware that those who don't do model making are kind of like, come on, stick it all together, see it all together. But I kind of have to slow myself down. Be like, it'll come eventually. No. Can't be rushed. Okay, so now we've got a nice little unit area there with some fire extinguishers, a couple of safety, some holy crap handles, things like that. Alright, so we're going to have a look here what else we've got. We've got another holy crap handle to paint white. A lot of units here, not sure what all that lot is. There's a cabinet here. Alright, so if we now paint this one, it's got a bit of a holy crap handle. Amu, I prefer greens that make me more buzz. What? Oh, you're talking about the vegetables. Oh, okay. My god, creamy. Opened to a couple of hours ago. It's good to have you here. I'm gonna say, who said that hours ago? Alright, which is the one? I'm just winding you up, creamy. You know me. He's teasing with cream moisture. She loves it, really. I was just having a convo about my comp with the manufacturer. Oh, I think it is the power supply too, so guess I'll get a new one. Yeah, it could be the power supply. It's a distinct possibility. That's just super annoying now. A new computer? No, won't be cheap. Have you asked him if you can, like, if he could just, like, put a new power supply in? Because other than that, your computer's pretty fine from what I understand. I mean, are you going to be able to just replace... I've only had it for like 3 to 4 years. Yeah, I mean, I bought my gaming one. It was really expensive, and the hope was that it would last for a few years, which, you know, hasn't got to that stage yet that I need to replace it, because it's still fucking banging. But, yeah, I mean, maybe you could just replace the... Need to check the instructions now. Maybe you could just replace the power supply? I don't know. Can you? What? Oh yeah, this unit. 21. Black boss. Yeah, it's not a piece of shit. I mean, sure, it's not top quality computer anymore, but then, you know, as soon as you buy a computer, it's out of date, so, you know, but it's no slouch from what I understand. So yeah, just see if you can maybe just get them to replace the power supply. I don't know. would have preferred to airbrush this, but I completely forgot about it. Yeah, I got advice from all you all when I put it together at CLX. Yeah, I remember that. Yeah. The first power supply, and I'll save up for a graphics card. Wait as long as I can for the really good ones to get outdated and go on sale. Have a word with your guy, because obviously the thing with that is whether you're now I'm no expert. People that are probably gonna be like, have different opinions, and that's fine. Don't tend to be an expert, I just know what I know. And I know what I don't know. You might want to speak to your guy, because not all, you're just going to replace the power supply like for like, that might be fine. If you're going to get a new one, as in an updated one, you might want to check to see, you know, what power requirements you need, whether it fits in with your motherboard. The same with the graphics card, not all motherboards can accept all graphics cards. So, you know, just have a full-on word with him. The last thing you want to do is buy a graphics card and then realize it's not going to fit. Wait. So this is a bit of a like worktop area. Now I'm assuming this could be used for I don't know, maybe this does go map. Need a bunch of maps and stuff. I'm wondering if this is like a worktop to prepare some, no, maybe they'd prepare food down in the galley, wouldn't they? They wouldn't do it up here in the cabin. Nah. Just looks like a kitchen unit, doesn't it? Oh, it's probably just a map desk or something. There we go. They're very good at customer service. Luckily, even told me they would walk me through installation of a new card. Nice. So yeah, you do want to make sure that you're getting what you need to get for months. Hi. Just looking up. What you do here. Okay. Oh, right. So I think I've been going for nearly 3 hours now. I've been doing quite a bit of painting. I didn't want to go on this long, but you know, it is. But I was having fun. I just, you know, couldn't help myself to keep going. But I think what's happening is now I'm starting to lose concentration. I could feel it in my brush strokes. So we're gonna leave it again for today. Let me come back to here. Let me just come to just chatting. Okay. Cigarette. So, what I'm going to do is I'm going to leave it for today. We've done the airbrushing. We've done quite a bit of detailed work. That deck of the... Oh, you're off, are you, Creamy? Okay, well, fine. Yeah, fair enough. The decking of the lifeboat is weathered and sort of detailed, and that's ready to accept building onto. I'm quite happy with that. So what we're going to do tomorrow is, I don't think there's going to be any airbrushing. It's going to be a bunch of detail work, dry brushing, weathering, and that sort of thing. And then hopefully we could start to glue some of this stuff onto the actual deck itself. So that would be kind of cool. So I think there's as good place to leave it as any. So yeah, I think that's pretty good. Pretty good place. So what we're going to do is we're just going to hit on stream ending here. I'm going to put these paints away so that I don't fucking hurt myself as I lean into the camera. Whisper sweet nothings. Yeah, so again, thank you for coming out. I know it's kind of slow paced and not a lot happens, but that's just model making in general, you know. If I decided to edit this down, which I don't, to put on YouTube, then what you'd do is you'd edit out the fun bits, and when you watch model making tubes, it all looks fun and interesting. Which, don't get me wrong, it is, but it's just so elongated out a little bit. It's just elongated out a little bit. So I hope you enjoyed the nice, chilled, relaxed stream today. I will come back tomorrow and do some more, and like I say, more painting and stuff. So I want to thank everybody for joining me. Let's see if there's anyone. There is no one streaming. So I tell you what, let's have a look. No one that I'm following is streaming at the moment. Well, there is. Let's see if we can find first by category, makers and crafting. Let's see if there's anyone makers and crafting that is doing something interesting. That's not the button I wanted to press. There we go. Makers and crafting. You're in here. Gundam. Someone's building a Gundam. Oh, you won't be able to understand that. That's in, I guess, in Chinese. I'm really feeling like I need to work in. What's this guy doing? No. All right. Well, this might be fun. Someone is in just streaming print. So someone is just streaming. It's just streaming some 3D printing. Pretty cool. He's putting a dragon and stuff. So I'll tell you what, we're gonna head out here. I'm going to start this raid. I'm gonna jump in there. I want to thank everyone for coming out, and I do appreciate it. And I will see you next time. Okay, let's just start this raid. And adios. Bye. Knows.